Brethren, when you call a man a doctor,
my people, when you call the person a doctor,
we know that's the man you want to call upon when you are sick.
We gonna say that's not the person you want to call when you are sick.
When you call a man a lawyer,
when you can call one man lawyer,
that's the man you turn to when you need somebody to advocate for you.
When you call a person a lawyer, that not the person when be say you want turn to when go help you judge a particular case for you.
When you call a man a banker, that's the man you want to call upon when you have some financial problems.
When you call one man banker, it means saying that not the person when be say you want turn to when you get money problem.
I don't know what Jesus is to you.
I don't know who Jesus Christ be to you.
He is my doctor.
Now he be my doctor.
He is my lawyer.
Now he be my lawyer.
He is my banker.
Now he be my banker.
He is my supporter.
Now he support me.
He is my defender.
Now he defend me.
Let's go ahead and tell him what he is.
Oh, tell Jesus Christ, who will be to us?
Tell him, Lord, you are my king.
Mo tell and say, Lord, now you be my king. Oh.
You are my Lord.
Now you be my Lord.
You are my physician.
Now you be my doctor.
You are my provider.
Now you dey provide for me.
You are my deliverer.
Now you dey deliver me from katakata.
You are my all in all.
Now you be my all in all.
You are my alpha.
Now you be my alpha.
You are my omega.
Now you be my omega.
You are my beginning.
Now you be my beginning.
You are my ending.
Now you be my ending.
You are my hope.
Now you be the hope when I get.
You are my joy.
Now you be the thing when they make me the happy.
You are my ambition.
Now you be what I plan to be.
You are my friend.
Now you be my friend.
You are my lover.
Now you be the person I love.
Oh, you are my promoter.
Now you be the person they promote.
You are the lifter up of my head.
Now you they lift my head up.
You are great, Lord.
Lord, you they great too.
You are everything to me.
Now you be everything to me.
Oh yes, you are my bright and morning star.
Now you be my bright and morning star.
I want you to know I love you.
I want to make you know say I love you.
There's no one like you as far as I'm concerned.
As I know, nobody be like you.
You are the only friend I can really trust.
Now you be the only better friend I will trust.
When I'm passing through the fire, you are the only one who will pass through it with me.
When I come to pass fire, now only you be the person who will pass through the fire with me.
You are my companion.
Now you be the person who follow me the duty.
You are my father.
Now you be my papa.
You are my origin.
Now you where I come from.
You are my hope.
Now you be the hope when I get.
You are my future.
Now you be what I go be. Now you be my future.
You are my all in all.
Now you be my everything.
Oh yes, I just want you to know I love you, Lord.
Papa, I want to make you know say I love you.
I love you.
I love you, Ewe.
I love you.
I love you, Papa.
I love you.
I love you.
I love you. I love you.
I love you. I love you, Papa.
Oh, I wish I can love you more.
I wish I feel love you more than the way I love you now.
Thank you, my Father.
Thank you, my Papa.
Glory be to your name.
Glory be unto your holy name.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
In Jesus' mighty name we all pray.
Father, we want to bless your holy name.
Papa, we want to bless your holy name.
Because you are all in all to us.
Because now you be everything to us.
You are our king.
Now you be our king, oh.
Our Lord.
Now you be our Lord.
Our physician.
Now you be our doctor.
Our savior.
Now you be our savior.
Our deliverer.
Now you be the person that deliver us from katakata.
Our provider.
Now you be provide for us.
Our defender.
Now you be the person when they wage war for us.
Our Lord of hosts.
Now you be our champion. When we say the defender. Defend us from every wahala when the devil they do against us.
Glory be to your holy name, Lord.
Glory be unto your holy name, Lord.
Accept our worship in Jesus' name.
Papa, may you collect our worship in Jesus' name.
Thank you for yesterday.
We thank you for yesterday.
Thank you for today.
We thank you for today.
Thank you in advance for tomorrow.
We will thank you down for tomorrow.
Glory be to your holy name.
Glory be unto your holy name.
Tonight, Father, please save souls.
This night, oh, Papa, will they pray make you come save souls? Oh.
Heal the sick.
Make you make those people when they're sick, make them come well.
Set the captives free.
Everybody, when we say they want wahala or the other, may you come deliver them.
Glorify your name.
Make your name they glorified.
At the end of everything, let us be able to praise you again.
After everything that happened, oh, make we still get mind, most still praise you again.
In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
In Jesus' mighty name, we all pray.
Amen.
Amen.
Let somebody shout hallelujah.
Make one person shout hallelujah.
God bless you. You may be seated.
God bless you. Now, please sit down.
Tonight, we want to continue with our study.
This night, we will continue with the topic we did the talk before.
Of the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob.
When be the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob.
Exodus chapter 3. We will just read verse 15.
Exodus chapter 3. Now only verse 15 we will read.
Exodus chapter 3. We will read verse 15.
Exodus chapter 3. Now only verse 15 we will read.
And God said, moreover, unto Moses.
God can't tell Moses as he don't tell him before.
Thus shalt thou say unto the children of Israel.
He said, now so you go talk to the people of Israel.
The Lord God of your fathers.
The papa of your papa.
The God of Abraham.
The God of Abraham.
The God of Isaac. And the God of Jacob.
The God of Isaac and the God of Jacob.
Has sent me unto you.
He don't send me make I come meet you now.
This is my name forever.
Now this be my name forever.
And this is my memorial unto all generations.
Now this one everybody will remember me with from generation to generation.
I have said before that if you really want to know what a man wants to be called.
And I'll talk before. Say if you really want to know what any man wants them to call him.
Ask him to introduce himself.
Make you tell that person, may he tell you now about himself.
Because many a times, your father may give you certain names.
Many times, so your papa will give you some name.
And for one reason or the other, you think that that name is not befitting enough.
Because of one reason or the other, if it is said that name not fit you at all.
So you want to call yourself by a different name.
So you won't give yourself another name when you say you like.
Many a times when you are called by the name you have chosen for yourself.
Many times when you say they can't call you by the name when you say you give yourself.
You always tend to do things better than when you are called by your regular official name.
You go want to do something better pass when they call you with the name when you say your papa and mama give you.
For example, there are people whose names are just a simple name like Ade.
Some people name simple like Ade.
But they think that Ade doesn't sound fine enough and they want to be known as Adesco.
They will say the name Ade not fit them at all. They will want people to call them Adesco.
I know because I see some Adesco around.
I know this one because I don't see many Adesco when they this place.
And of course, you find all kinds of complicated names coming out of simple ones.
Now, so you can't see many harder names when they come out from some simple names.
I know a professor, for example, I will not look in his direction.
I know one professor, Motekan, for example, I'm not going to look to where he is sitting.
I will just call his normal name to be Folorunsho.
I will just call his name when they know him to be as Folorunsho.
But he prefers to be known as Afilifoli.
But he won't make people they call him Afilifoni.
If you think you know the one I'm talking about, you are mistaken.
If you say you know the person when they talk about, you just deceive yourself.
Let somebody shout hallelujah.
Let somebody shout hallelujah.
And I've been talking about these names for some time, and one day, one of my sons turned to me and said, Daddy, what is your name?
I know they talk about this name for many, many times. One day, my picking turned to face me because say, Papa, what will be your own name?
When you were in school.
When you did school.
And I told him that they used to call me Ade Mathematics.
I can't tell him, I said, Ade Mathematics that they called me.
He wasn't impressed.
Yeah, I will not satisfy him at all.
He said, is that all?
He said, nah, all of them be that.
I said, is that not big enough? He said, no, no, no.
I can't ask him, I said, that will not be Grish. He said, no.
Don't you have another name? A name that you bear, particularly when you used to be a boxer.
He said, you don't get any name. That name when we say you bear, that time when you see the boss.
He said, something big.
Say name when we say they big well well.
I said something as big as what?
I can't tell and say the name went big as waiting.
Well, he said something like Burkina Faso Pajarito.
He can't say something like Burkina Faso Pajarito.
I said, God, God have mercy.
I said, God, do I be sorry for us. So.
But here you find the Almighty God introducing himself.
Yeah, we can't see God. Now in himself, they tell us who he be.
He had already said, my name is I am that I am.
He don't already tell us, now he be the I am, we be the I am.
But then three times in one chapter.
For three times for one chapter.
He introduced himself as the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob. Three times in one single chapter.
He can't tell us, and I be the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. Three times for one chapter.
And I think that down the ages, he wants us to pay attention to this particular name.
I believe, say, if they try to tell us as time they go, make we take note of this name
that he has chosen for himself.
When he does select for himself.
As the Bible will later on tell you.
As the Bible can't tell us.
He calls himself the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob.
Say, if they call himself the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob.
Because he's a God of the living. Not a God of the dead.
Now the God of those people when they live, not be the God of those people when they die.
So that we will be able to know down the ages that.
So we can know later as time they go, say.
Even though people might sleep in the flesh.
Even though people when know Jesus Christ before they die, can't die.
But they are still alive in the Lord.
Although they don't die, you, they still they live inside Jesus Christ.
It's something that is important that we need to take note of because we won't be able to go into details on that.
This one, they're very important because we're not going to talk much on them.
That when you die here on earth, that is not the end of the story.
When you can't die for this earth, the story not end that way.
If you die in Christ, your enjoyment has just started.
If you can't die inside Jesus Christ, your enjoyment just begins.
If you die without Christ, your suffering has just started.
When you die, you not get Jesus Christ inside you, your suffer just begins.
I pray that by the time you leave this world, you will be with the Lord in Jesus' name.
I pray, say, before you leave this earth, so now inside Jesus Christ, you go there in Jesus' name.
But because of time.
Because of time.
Let us zero in on the fact that he calls himself the God of Abraham.
We just discuss about the name when he called himself the God of Abraham.
And just take seven important points.
We can take seven important points
from that aspect alone.
From this topic, the God of Abraham.
Who is the God of Abraham?
Now, who be this God of Abraham?
Number one. The God of Abraham is a God of choice.
Number one, the God of Abraham is the God when they select something.
There were several people in the family of Abraham.
Many people there inside the family of Abraham.
But God chose Abraham for a very special purpose.
God can't select Abraham for one better assignment.
If you read Genesis chapter 12, verse 1.
For Genesis chapter 12, verse 1.
You will hear that, and God said unto Abraham.
You hear the Bible talk, say, and God can't talk to Abraham.
Before that time, the only thing we had about Abraham is that he's the son of so and so, of the family of so and so.
Before that time, but what you just hear about Abraham now is the picking of so and so from the family of so and so.
There was nothing special said about Abraham.
Nothing there very important about Abraham.
It wasn't written that Abraham was a holy man.
They don't write and say Abraham a person when they live holy life.
It wasn't written that Abraham loved the Lord.
They don't write and say Abraham can't like God well.
It wasn't written that Abraham served the Lord.
They don't say Abraham can't serve God.
He just came and God said unto Abraham.
But the Bible just tells us, say, and God can't come, can't talk to Abraham.
He just chose Abraham.
He just selected Abraham.
And as we will discover, if you read the story further, he did not choose Lot.
As we can read later, we will see, say, Lot, so God not choose him.
He chose Abraham.
Now only Abraham is select.
I have good news for you.
I get good news for now.
You are here today because God has chosen you.
When are they here? Because God does select you now.
Because there are several people who could have been here right now.
Because many people were supposed to be here now.
Who heard what you heard about this meeting?
Where can hear what you hear about this meeting?
Who saw what you saw about this meeting?
Where can see what you now see about this meeting?
And who are not doing anything specific at home right now?
But they don't do anything special for us now.
But they are not choosing to be partakers of 3 days blessing.
But they never select them to be people when go enjoy the 3 days blessing.
That's why they are not here.
That be the reason they're not there.
The God of Abraham chose you to be here.
The God of Abraham not just select you, make you come day here.
So that your life will never be the same again.
So that your life will never be the same again.
Do I hear amen to that?
I feel hear amen to that.
He is the God of choice.
God, now the God when we say they select something.
Because the Bible says in Psalm 115 verse 3.
Because Bible can't talk for Psalm 115 verse 3.
Psalm 115 verse 3.
Psalm 115 verse 3.
He said, our God is in the heavens. He does as he pleases.
He said, our God that heaven he do as he like now he do.
He just decided, this fellow Abraham, I am choosing him.
He just talk for a man, say, this person Abraham, I don't choose him.
Abraham was born in a house where they worship idols.
Abraham, that the house of people they worship juju, for born him.
God still chose him.
God still select him.
There was nothing specific up to that moment about Abraham that could qualify him for divine choice. But God still chose him.
Nothing special about Abraham before God can select him. But God still select him.
I thank God that God is a God of choice.
I thank God. Say God now person will be see they select.
I have said it before and again and again that I thank God that if God were not a dictator, a good one.
I don't talk and many times say, if God not be a person when we say talk sometimes, the thing will be like that.
There are many of us here who will never get to heaven.
Many of us, they here when we will reach heaven.
If God were to be a Democrat.
If God na person when we say, as people talk and as well, it will be.
If God were to ask our friends.
If God can't ask our brains.
To vote. Whether or not we should be saved.
Whether God's supposed to save us or not.
Many of us will go to hell.
Many of us in the fire will find ourselves.
I know my friends will not vote for me to be born again.
And also my friend, they're not going to vote for me make a day born again.
Because they know that the moment I become born again, we will no longer be able to drink like we used to drink together.
Because they know say the moment when we say I don't day born again, they're not going to feel they follow me, they drink the way that they drink with me again.
We will not be able to do all those horrible things we used to do together.
They know so we're not going to do all those air things when we saw they do together before.
But the Almighty God looked among those people who were heaven, who were hell bent.
God can look all these people when we say that air fire they work out, they go.
And picked me out. And say, you, I have chosen you.
Can't look all of them. Can't see me. And he can't say, you, I don't select you.
I believe the same God has chosen somebody here tonight.
I believe say that same God does select one person for this place this night.
Let that fellow shout hallelujah.
Will that person shout hallelujah?
If God were not a God of choice.
If God not be God when we say they select something.
There is no way David would have become king.
In not get asked, David will come become king.
Because even his father would not have voted for him.
Because even his papa not would agree vote for him.
As far as his brothers were concerned, he didn't even qualify for being made a king.
As he come be, he better not even believe say they qualify to become king.
And when God chose him and anointed him to be king,
you go see say after God don't anoint David,
you will notice that the day David reported at the battlefront,
after they don't anoint David, the next time David comes see himself for where for the fight
and wanted to confront Goliath, even his brother said he should just go back to the farm.
He can't tell, say, who be this person when we say they challenge the people of Israelite? Now, your own brother say, I better go back, go ask, go meet your papa.
They felt that this boy will never rise beyond being a shepherd boy.
They believe, say, this boy no go feel better pass to the take care of sheep.
But the God of Abraham chose him.
But this God of Abraham can select him.
And I know there is someone here that God has chosen for something great.
And also one person there when God does select for some 2 and 3 great.
If you are the one, let me hear you say amen again.
If now you be the person, I want me you shout amen again.
And I want you to know that even when it comes to the issue of salvation,
when can they talk about that issue of salvation?
When it comes to the issue of coming to Christ,
when they talk about how a person will come to Jesus Christ,
there are many of us who would think that it is our ability or our wisdom or our common sense.
Many of us go to sin up with the sense one will get by the way we walk, by the way we do things,
that cause us to surrender our life to Jesus.
Even with our common sense, that make us go hand over our life to Jesus Christ.
But according to the word of Jesus Christ, the one whose name is the truth.
But according to the word when Jesus Christ can talk, the one when be saying name now the truth.
According to what he said in John chapter 6, verse 44.
According to what he talked for John chapter 6, verse 44.
John 6, 44.
John 6, verse 44.
He said, no man can come unto me except my father draws him.
He said, nobody will come meet me except my papa bring and come.
I want you to know that if you are saved today, you are saved because God chose you for salvation.
I want me you know, say, if today you don't save, you don't inside Jesus Christ, so that because Jesus Christ does select you, make you come to him.
Because God brought you.
And because God now bring you.
There were several people who had the same sermon that you had.
Many people, they went beside all year, the same message when they hear.
And they refused to respond to the altar call.
And they now agree, come out, come give their life to Christ.
Just as tonight, there will be people who are hearing what they are hearing now.
Like this night, well, I believe say some people there when we say they go to hear what you will hear now.
And they will know it is God knocking at the door of their heart.
And they will know now Jesus Christ they knock their heart.
And yet when we ask those who want to give their life to Jesus, they will not surrender.
And when we call for those people who won't give their life to Jesus Christ, so they're not going to agree come outside.
Because the Father just did not bring them.
Because God not will draw them come Jesus Christ.
I pray that if you are one of such people, before we finish, the Almighty God would have chosen you for salvation in Jesus' name.
I pray God, say if you be one of those kind people, I believe, say before we finish, your God will not select you, make you come inside Jesus Christ in Jesus' name.
I know one professor here who today is one of our pastors, is not present here right now.
I know one professor when they did school, when be one of our pastors now, although he not did this place this night.
But he said that on the day he gave his life to Jesus Christ, he would not have given his life to Jesus Christ if NEPA has not taken off life.
He said the day when he can't give his life to Jesus Christ, if he will not give his life to Jesus Christ, if NEPA not going to take light.
Just at the moment when they made the altar call, the light went.
He said as they thought, say, those people won't give their life to Jesus Christ, come forward, NEPA just take light.
And so out of the darkness, he was bold enough to stand for Jesus Christ.
He said, when everywhere come dark, that one can't give him boldness, can't stand for Jesus Christ.
You see, once God has chosen you, he will move heaven and earth to make sure that you arrive where you are going to arrive at.
If God does select you, go make sure, say, heaven and earth work for your favor so that you can't get to that place when he does select you to get to.
And I know somebody will arrive at a very good destination.
I know, say, one person when they go can't reach the good place when God will arrange for her.
Do I hear you say amen again?
I feel hear you say amen again.
He chooses who to save.
God, they select who he go save.
And he chooses who to bless.
And he comes, they select who he go bless.
When you read Luke chapter 5, from verse 1 to 7.
When you can read Luke chapter 5, verse 1, go read 7.
Luke 5, verse 1 to 7.
Luke chapter 5, verse 1, go read 7.
The Bible tells us that when Jesus Christ got to that beach on that day.
The Bible can't tell us, so when Jesus Christ can't reach the riverside, for that day,
he found two boats.
Now two canoes I see.
One belonged to Peter, and one belonged to other people.
One, now Peter and I get him. The other one, another person I get him.
There were two boats to choose from.
Two canoes do when Jesus Christ go select from.
He chose the boat of Peter.
Now Peter boat now he select.
He chose the boat that he will fill to overflowing with fish.
He can't select the canoe when he say you can't fool with fish later.
He chose the boat of someone who will become a leader of the Christian church.
He select the boat of the person when later that person will be the leader of Christian.
He chose because he's a God of choice.
He select because that God when they select.
I pray that today he will also choose you for blessing in Jesus' name.
I pray this day, say, go choose you for blessing in Jesus' name.
Then number two.
The number two.
Who is this God of Abraham?
Now, who be this God of Abraham?
He's a God of promise.
Now, God when they make promise.
In Genesis chapter 12, like I mentioned earlier on, if you read it now from verse 1 to 3.
For Genesis chapter 12, as I not talked before, if you can read that for 1, go reach 3.
Genesis 12, verse 1 to 3.
Genesis chapter 12, verse 1, go reach 3.
The Bible said, and God said unto Abraham, I want you to do the following things.
God can't talk to Abraham. Say, Abraham, I won't make you do this thing, no.
Get out of your father's house.
Come on from your papa's house.
Get out of your country.
Come on from the country where you did.
Get out of your kindred.
Come on, leave those people where you stay with.
Because I've chosen you for something special.
Because I just select you for something way better.
You do these three things. He said, I will do seven things for you.
If you can't do these three things, so now seven things I will do for you.
I will make of you a great nation.
I will come make you. Now you will come be a great nation.
I will make your name great.
I will come make your name, make it big way way.
I will bless you.
I will come bless you, Yafu Yafu.
I will make you a blessing.
I will come make you to the blessed people.
I will bless those who bless you.
I will bless those people when they bless you.
I will curse those who curse you.
Anybody who curse you, I will curse them.
And through you shall the whole earth be blessed.
And now through your blessing will come the whole earth.
I am sure if you are Abraham, you will wonder, God, what have I done?
I believe so. If you be Abraham, you will wonder, say, God, what you have done do?
That you are making all these promises unto me.
When you come, they give me all these better promises.
Everyone that God chooses, he promises them great things.
Anybody when we say God does select, he promise them better things.
He said, he was saying to this man, not only will I bless you, you will be a blessing.
He said, not the only say I will bless you, you will bless others.
I know somebody is here who's also going to become a blessing.
I know say one person there when go come become blessing to others.
And he said that anyone who blesses you will become blessed.
He said, anybody when we say come bless you, he said that person automatically the person will be blessed.
And anyone who dares curses you, he said that fellow will become my enemy.
He said, anybody when come they curse you, that person that my enemy don't become.
I like the God of Abraham.
I like this God of Abraham.
He's a God of promises.
Now God when they promise.
And not only does he make promises, he's able to fulfill.
Not be only say they feel they promise, so they feel they keep to his promise.
Whatever promises he will make.
Any promise when he don't make.
I was talking to my people yesterday. I said, listen.
And they talked to my people yesterday. It's more than listening, though.
There are many times men have disappointed us.
Many times they when we say man, don't disappoint us.
They have disappointed us. Not always because they want to disappoint us.
They don't want to disappoint us because they want to disappoint us. So.
Some disappointed us because they died.
Some of them disappoint us because death can't carry them go.
Before they could fulfill their promises.
Before they can't do what they tell us they go do.
Some disappointed because the means they wanted to use to fulfill the promises just didn't come.
Some of them can't disappoint us because what they want you to answer us concerning that promise, that thing not going to come.
But there is a God who will never disappoint you.
But one God there will not go feel disappoint us.
He will never disappoint you because he can never die.
He not go feel disappoint you because he not go feel die.
He will never disappoint you because everything he needed to fulfill his promises, he already has.
He not gonna disappoint you because everything when he did to take fulfill this he promise, so he already get out.
And he has some promises for you, those of you who are already chosen by him.
And he gave some promises when he don't promise you. All those people when he say they already select.
Some of these promises are written in Isaiah chapter 41. You can read them from verse 10 to 13.
Some of these promises, so they don't write them. For Isaiah chapter 41, from 10 to go reach 13.
Isaiah 41, from verse 10 to 13.
Isaiah chapter 41, verse 10, go reach 13.
I can summarize it for you.
Have you talked short for now?
He simply says, I will help you.
He just means, say, I will help you.
I think that is enough.
I believe, say, that one don't reach.
If all the promise that God has made towards you is, I will help you, I think that is enough.
If every promise when God don't make to you, say, nah, I go help you, that one don't reach you.
It means I will help you academically.
It means I go help you for your school work. Oh.
I will help you financially.
I go help you concern money matter.
I will help you mentally.
I go help you so that you feel they think well.
I will help you maritally.
I go help you for even your marriage.
I will help you spiritually.
I go help you for your spiritual life.
I will help you when you want to climb.
I go help you when you want climb.
I will help you when you want to sleep.
I go help you when you want sleep.
I will help you when you want to eat.
I will help you if you want eat.
And he said, not only will I help you, Anybody who rises up against you,
is it not the only thing I go help you? But anybody when me say won't make katakata with you.
By the time I finish with them, you will look for them, you won't find them.
See, by the time I don't deal with that person, you go find that person, you're not gonna see the person again.
I thought you should say amen to that one.
I think someone go say amen to that one.
And when he makes a promise,
I want Mokona to say, if God makes a promise,
I want you to know that if it came from God,
and this promise can't come from God,
it will come to pass.
That promise, you don't get as it be, it will happen.
No matter how big, no matter how incredible, no matter how impossible it may sound,
you don't get how the promise big rich, you don't get how the promise large rich, you don't get how the thing looks say, you know, go fear happen.
If God said it,
if God not talk him,
it is already settled.
It already they settled.
Someone came to me the other day and said,
one person come meet me and say,
Daddy, at the beginning of the year, God said the following towards me.
Papa, as the year they start, God can't tell me this thing.
I am still waiting.
And they see the way to.
I said, my son,
I can't tell him, I said, my pikin,
let's go back and review all the prophecies for this year.
We'll go back, we'll go reread all what God will tell us for this year.
And see how many of them had already come to pass.
And we could see how many of them had happened.
The Lord said,
God can't say
that this year, there will be earthquakes.
This year, we will get the earth to shake.
Has there been any?
Would all experience anyone?
Oh, he said many.
He said yes, so many of them.
He said this year, there will be floods.
God said this year, many water will overflow for the land.
I said, have you been watching CNN?
I ask and say, you know this, watch CNN.
He said, I've been watching the CNN. Have you seen floods? He said, I've seen quite a lot.
He said, I watch CNN. I can ask and say, you don't see flood. He said, you don't see plenty. Where, where?
He said, this year, some volcanoes will erupt again.
He told me, this year, those fire when they come out from rock will burst out again.
Have you seen that? He said, I've seen them.
I ask and say, you don't see that one? He said, yes, I don't see him.
If he said one thing,
if he can't talk one thing,
and it comes to pass, whatsoever he has said concerning you will come to pass also.
And that thing can happen. Everything when he don't talk about you will also happen.
Do I hear amen to that one?
I feel hear amen to that one.
Remember years ago, 1981.
I remember many years went up past from 1981.
When I became the general overseer.
When you come make me the general overseer.
I left the University of Ilorin. I was living in a mansion.
I live the big house when I live for University of Ilorin.
In those days in the university, in Ilorin, you can hire a whole house for 40 naira.
Before for Ilorin, if you hire one big house for 40 naira.
Because there were houses and there were nobody to live in them.
Because many houses there and nobody there when they say go live inside them.
So my house then, as acting head of Department of Mathematics.
Me when be the acting head of Mathematics Department.
Let's forget the main house and talk about the boys' quarters.
We could forget about the real house. More talk about the boys' quarter.
The boys' quarters has 4 rooms.
The boys' quarter now 4 rooms now you get.
And then I had a flat for guest room.
I can still get another flat when we say people when come see me go stay.
That flat has 2 bedrooms.
And that flat now 2 bedrooms you get.
So that will give you a rough idea what my main house must have been like.
When you can't put that one together, you can't understand how my house can be rich.
And then I had to leave that one to come and live in 1 room in Mushi.
I go leave that one and I'll come Mushi, can't live for 1 room.
Because I became general overseer.
Because they don't make me general overseer.
And I said, God, I don't mind.
I can't say, God, oh, I don't mind. Oh.
But then when it was, my wife, meanwhile, was working with the university and she couldn't move over immediately.
My wife, now the university they work with, oh, so my wife, if you follow me, come Mushi.
But when September was drawing near, and she was going to come and join me in Lagos.
When September they reached, because she will come meet me for Lagos.
I prayed to God.
I can't pray, go give God.
God, I don't mind living in a room.
I can't say, God, though, I don't mind if I want room at the stay.
I don't need more than a room anyway.
I don't want more than 1 room. Oh.
But my wife is coming.
Then my wife, they come.
I'm coming with the children.
And they come with our pikin.
If you don't mind.
I say, God, though, if you don't mind, I beg.
Give me a boys' quarter.
If not only boys' quarter, I beg, give me.
That will have at least 1 room for the children.
We will get 1 room for the children.
And 1 room for my wife and I, if you don't mind.
And 1 room for me and my wife, if you don't mind.
And the Lord answered and said, son, don't ask me for a house. Because I've decided to build you a city.
God can't answer me, say, my pikin, no, they ask me for a house, so because now a city I won't build for you.
And when I heard that one, I couldn't understand. What do you mean you want to build me a city? You want to drive the people in Lagos away from me?
I don't understand this one. I said, what do you mean, say you go build me a city? It means say you won't drive people when they Lagos come off for me.
Today we know where the city is.
Today we know where the city is.
Let's give the Lord a big hand.
Let we clap for God.
The God of Abraham is a God of promise.
The God of Abraham is a God when he makes promise.
And when he promises, he will bring it to pass.
And when he can't promise, that promise will come to pass.
Tell the fellow next to you, don't lose hope.
Tell the person when sit down near you, make you not discourage you.
He will fulfill his promise for you.
What he told you, go bring her to pass.
And then this God of Abraham is a God of friendship.
This God of Abraham, a God when they make friends.
A God of love.
A God when they say love.
In Genesis chapter 18, if you read verse 17 there.
For Genesis chapter 18, if you read verse 17 for there.
Genesis 18 verse 17. He said,
Genesis chapter 18 verse 17, it also says,
can I hide what I'm going to do from Abraham?
He said, I hide what he won't do from Abraham.
Knowing that he is going to order his family.
Abraham will come direct to Pekin
after him to follow me.
Make them follow God the way Abraham did follow God.
In other words, he was saying, Abraham is my friend.
He thought say Abraham my friend.
I can't hide anything from him.
I don't go if he hide anything from him.
That God wants to be your friend also.
That God that your friend he won't be also.
He wants to walk with you in fellowship. He wants to walk with you in love.
He wants the fellowship with you. He won't walk out with you with love.
In John chapter 15, verse 15.
For John chapter 15, verse 15.
John 15, verse 15.
For John 15, verse 15.
He said, you are my friend.
He said, you are my friend.
He said, I don't call you servants anymore because servants don't know what their master does.
He said, I know they call you servants again because servants know they know what their God they do.
But I've called you friends because anything I receive from my father, I've made it known unto you.
He said, I call you friends because anything when my papa show me or tell me, I don't tell you now, I don't show you.
There are all categories of people in the world. There are people who call themselves creatures of God.
Different kind of people they this world do. Some people now the creature of God that they call themselves.
Which is correct.
That one still they correct.
There are people who call themselves by some other big name.
Some other people they want they call themselves a big name.
But we as children of the living God, we are bold enough to say we are friends of God.
But we, as speaking of the living God, we get that boldness, that courage to talk, say, we'll be friend of God.
How many friends of God are here tonight?
How many friends of God did this place this night?
Let me hear you shout hallelujah.
Make a hear on a shout hallelujah.
And because he loves you, because he wants to be your friend.
Because he can't like you, because he wants you to be a friend.
That's why the Bible says in Romans chapter 8 verse 37.
I make the Bible can't talk for Romans chapter 8 verse 37.
Romans 8 verse 37.
Romans chapter 8 verse 37.
He said, we are more than conquerors.
We did better than the person when we say they all win battle.
Through him that loved us.
Through Jesus Christ when they all like us.
We are not more than conquerors because we know how to pray.
We not better pass the person when we say they all win battle because we know how to pray.
We are not more than conquerors because we know how to give, even though praying and giving is important.
We not better pass the person when we say don't win battle because we know how to give money, even though to pray and to give is important.
But we are more than conquerors simply because he loves us.
We did better pass the person when we win battle because Jesus Christ loves us.
The reason I know that before we start a battle, we have won.
The reason of which I know, say before we start any battle, we don't already win now.
It's because of the one who loves us.
And because Jesus Christ, he loves us.
The God of Abraham is a God of love.
The God of Abraham, now God when they love.
Is a God who loves the world so much.
Now God when we say love the world, so say
that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life.
He can't give his only pikin when he gets, make he can't die for us. Say anybody when believe on this, he pikin when die for us, the person not go perish you, but he go get everlasting life.
He's a God who, because he loves you, understands how you are feeling.
Now God, when love you, so say he can't understand what you they feel for body.
He knows your weaknesses.
He knows the place where we say you they weak.
He knows your strength.
He knows the place where we say you get strength.
And he's more than willing to come down to your level and keep you company.
He they willing to come down, come your level, make it come they follow you, they be friends.
Years ago, I think again it was in 1981.
Many years will not pass, so I believe say in 1981.
I have been ministering since morning. In those days we were few.
I know they minister to people from morning. Those days were they small.
Anybody who comes and wants to see the GO, oh, they are more than welcome.
Anybody when come that time say you want to see GO, that person, no, they welcome.
But this particular day, I remember I have been ministering to people from 8 a.m. to 6 o'clock.
This particular time, oh, I know they minister to people from 8 a.m. go reach 6 p.m. for an evening.
One fellow after the other, one fellow after the other. I was younger then, I was stronger.
From one person to another person, from one person to another person. Are they young that time? I get energy well.
And then it was 6 o'clock. The final fellow, now I thought I'd left.
By 6 o'clock, oh, the last person went in the queue, I had to say, don't go.
And then all of a sudden, I heard the choir singing.
At once, so I can't hear the choir they sing.
It was time for the evening program, Digging Deep.
Time don't reach when we say we can't do evening program, Digging Deep.
So quickly, and then remember I've not eaten anything. Quickly, I got my notes ready. I went and I had Digging Deep.
Quickly, I don't even eat anything. I can't arrange my book. I can't go church. I can't do the Digging Deep.
As soon as we finish Digging Deep, I came back to my office, and before you know what is happening, there was a long queue of people who wanted to see me.
As we finished Digging Deep, I can't come to my office. So before I know, people don't line up on my door to wait me.
And now my body was aching.
Now my body doesn't shake because hungry don't come and I don't tired.
I said, oh God, do I have to pray for these people again? Can't you see that I am tired?
I can't say, oh God, I will come pray for these people again. You know, if you see, say, I don't tire.
Can't you see that my body is aching?
You know, if you see, say, my body, they shake.
I was talking to God, not to anyone else.
And they talk to God, not be anybody that they talk to.
And he said, I said, I can't even stand.
I can't talk, say, God, see me, oh, I don't feel even stand, though.
He said, who asked you to stand?
So who tells me you stand?
Sit down.
He said, make you sit down.
All they wanted is that you lay your hands upon them.
He said, all waiting they want, now make you lay your hand on them.
Up to that moment, I never thought that you could sit down and pray.
Up to that time, I don't know, say, person feel sit down, they pray.
I thought it would be disrespectful to God.
And he said, that thing not good, though. You not respect God, though.
But he said, sit down.
Now he can't tell me, see, make us sit down.
This God is a friend.
This God is a friend.
He doesn't mind sitting down when you pray.
He don't mind if you sit down and pray to him.
Particularly when you are tired.
Especially when you don't get tired.
I think I know what I'm talking about.
I believe, sir, I know it here at the talk.
Let somebody shout hallelujah.
Let somebody shout hallelujah.
I told my children recently, I said there's a passage in the Bible that is written principally for me.
I don't tell my children not to say, you get one particular Bible verse, and because of me, the right time.
He says, let the weak say, I am strong.
The Bible verse say, make those people when weak, to say, are they strong?
I think it's written for tired people.
I believe, say, that one, the writer for people when they're tired.
And I am number one among them.
Me, I be number one among them.
Glory be to God.
Glory be unto God.
But he wants to be your friend.
God, he won't be your friend.
And you know the fact that he wants to be your friend should give you joy.
Because this God won't be your friend, that thing is supposed to make you the day happy.
Because again and again, human beings will disappoint you.
Because as it happens, for one time to the other, human beings will disappoint you.
But God will never disappoint you.
But God, he not go feel disappoint you.
He will always be by your side.
By your side, he go always there.
Even when the people you trust most let you down.
Even those people when we say you trust, because you believe them, they can't disappoint you.
When the pastor disappoints.
When the pastor can't disappoint you.
When the man who brought you to Christ disappoints.
When the man who can carry you come, Jesus Christ can't disappoint you.
Jesus will not disappoint you.
Jesus Christ is not going to disappoint you.
I know what I'm talking about.
I know what you are talking about.
And I'm sure some of you do too.
I believe so, some of you understand this also.
But then let's go on. Who is this God of Abraham?
Let me continue. Who be this God of Abraham?
The God of Abraham is a God of greatness.
This God of Abraham, now God of greatness.
Genesis 24, verse 34 to 35.
For Genesis chapter 24, from 34 to 35.
Genesis 24, verse 34 to 35.
Genesis chapter 24, verse 34 to 35.
A man was speaking here and he said, I am Abraham's servant.
One man they talk for this place, say, in Abraham's servant.
And God has blessed my master greatly.
Say, God, oh, bless my master Abraham. Well.
And he went on to say how God has blessed him.
Can they talk how God oh, bless this master Abraham?
And he went on to say that his master has become great.
He can't they continue. I can't talk, say, this master Abraham, oh, he does the great.
If the God of Abraham is your God, there is no way you can die small.
If this God of Abraham are your God, he not get as he be when you can't die small.
Do I hear amen to that?
I feel hear amen to that.
He takes pleasure in making people great.
It is sweeter for body to make people day great.
God of Abraham, God of Isaac, God of Jacob, as we will discover when we continue probably tomorrow.
God of Abraham, God of Isaac, God of Jacob, as we will see what we will come to study around tomorrow.
All the three people that God decided to associate himself with, there's not a poor one among them.
All the three people when God can't join himself to, none of them they poor.
That's good news for you.
Now good news to you.
No matter how poor you are today, you are not going to die poor.
You not get as you poor rich, you not go fit die poor.
You better say amen loud and clear.
And I better say amen, no, make it loud and clear.
Now I know that the moment I say that one, there will be some people who will already be on guard. He wants to talk about prosperity.
And no say as I not talk this one, some people already ready themselves will say, Pastor won't talk about prosperity.
I don't know why people don't want to hear about prosperity.
I wonder why some people don't want to hear about prosperity.
Agreed, there are some people who have spoken about prosperity in a way that had become nauseating.
Agreed, some people don't talk about prosperity in a way when we say we're not good at all.
But the mere fact that a motor has an accident on the expressway does not mean that I will not ride a motor tomorrow.
You know what I mean? Say because motor can get accident for road, because of that, I not go can't drive my motor.
The fact that somebody does not know how to handle the word of God accurately does not mean that the word of God is no longer true.
You know what I mean? Say because somebody don't know how to handle the word of God correctly, you know me say the word of God not the truth.
God is the God of Abraham. Abraham was great.
God not the God of Abraham. Abraham now great person he be.
Is the God of Isaac. Isaac became very great.
Now God of Isaac, oh, Isaac, oh, he can't be great past Abraham.
Is the God of Jacob. Jacob became exceedingly great.
This God, the God of Jacob, oh, Jacob can't be great past both Abraham and Isaac.
If he's the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob, I am going to become great.
This God, the God of Abraham, God of Isaac, and God of Jacob, myself, oh, I go day great.
And remember, he said in Jeremiah chapter 29, verse 11.
Remember what he talked about, Jeremiah chapter 28, verse 11.
Jeremiah 28, verse 11.
Jeremiah chapter 28, verse 11.
He said, I know the thoughts that I think towards you.
He said, I know what you are they think towards you.
Thoughts of good, not of evil.
He said, what you are they think towards you now, thinking when they good, not thinking when they bad.
Poverty is evil. Everybody knows that one.
To poor, now evil thing, I believe everybody know that one.
Like I said at the last Holy Ghost service, I have tasted both sides.
As I don't talk for last Holy Ghost service, I don't taste the two sides though.
I have tasted poverty, I have tasted wealth.
I don't taste to be poor, I don't taste to get money.
I'm telling you, one is better than the other.
And I tell you now, one better pass the other one.
I have known how to walk naked, I mean barefooted, for the first 18 years of my life.
I don't know how to work out say you are not wear shoe for the first 18 years of my life.
Whether it rained or shine.
Whether rain they fall or sun they shine.
Now I know how to walk with shoes on my feet.
Now I don't know how to wear shoe they walk.
I prefer shoes on my feet. What about you?
I prefer to wear shoe for my leg they walk. What about you now?
I can never forget my final year in the grammar school.
I'm not going to forget the last time for grammar school.
That was my 18th year.
That one, at the time when I be 18 years.
I was a fairly good student, so I won some prizes.
I know book quite well, so I can't win some prizes.
And in those days in the grammar school, Elisha Grammar School, they used to have what they call the prize giving day.
For Elisha Grammar School, for those days, they get the day when they call prize giving day.
That's the day before the school will vacate.
Now that day, before people can't go on holiday.
When all those who won prizes will come forward, shake the hand of the principal, and receive a prize.
When everybody, when we say win prize, who can't come forward, they can't shake the principal's hand, they can't collect their prize, go.
For the subject where they had excelled.
For that subject when we say they pass and well.
Now, for the fellow in the final year, there is a dress code. You are supposed to come forward in white trouser, white shirt, and shoe on your feet.
For those people when we say that they are final year, they're supposed to come outside with white trouser, white shirt, and they were supposed to wear shoes.
I've won a prize.
I don't win the prize.
I have no trouser, whether white or black or red.
I don't get trouser, whether white, black or red.
Shoes, I don't even know what is so called.
Shoe, I don't know what they call shoe.
So what am I going to do?
So what's here I can't do now?
They are going to call my name. The whole family of every member of the parents of the children will be seated.
They will not call my name when everybody, parents and their family sit down and they look.
Am I going to go forward in the only nika that I have, barefooted?
I'm supposed to go outside with the only nika when I get, no wear shoe.
I was saying, God, when you know I have no trouser, why did you allow me to win a prize?
I can't tell God, if you know sir, I don't get trouser, why you can't allow me make I can't win prize?
It was at that stage when one of the boys in the hostel said, Ademas, and I said, yes.
Now that time, one student went in the hostel, come to say, Ademas, I come to say, yes.
He said, please come.
He said, I beg, come here.
And I went to him.
I can't go meet him.
He said, I have 6 trousers.
Come tell me, say, I get 6 trousers.
I don't know which one to choose to wear.
I don't know which one I go choose when I go come here.
Can you help me choose?
He can't tell me, say, if you help me choose one.
Now tell me which is better.
No more now tell me which one come better.
No trouser or 6 trousers. Which one do you prefer?
No trouser and 6 trousers. Which one you can't like?
So I helped him to choose one.
I could help him choose one.
And after I chose one, I said, I don't even have one to wear.
After I don't help him choose one, I can't say, but you know, sir, I don't get one to wear.
He said, pick one.
You can't say, collect one now.
And the boy is several feet taller than myself.
This boy, you tall past me well.
But a trouser is a trouser.
But trouser and a trouser.
Glory be to God.
Glory be to God.
So I chose one.
I can't take one trouser.
And when I wore it, I had to put it at my chest.
When I wear this trouser, I draw and go richest.
Now the problem of trouser was solved.
Now the problem of trouser was solved.
The next thing was now the problem of shoes.
Now the problem when I get now the problem of shoes.
And I remember I have an uncle somewhere.
I can't remember. I said, I get one uncle for one place.
It was as poor as anybody, but I think I have seen shoes on his feet before.
This is my uncle, poor, well, but I believe, sir, I don't see him wear shoes before.
So I went to see him, and I asked for shoes.
I can't go meet him. I can't beg him for shoes.
The one I saw with him, which was a decent one, he said, I can't let that one go.
The one when I see when he wear, when fire, well, he said, no go feel leave him for me.
But he had one sandal, which have been reborn.
He gets one sandal when we say they don't repackage them again.
And those of you who know what we used to call old Dutola tire sole in those days.
Most of us will know Dutola tire sole in those days.
Ha ha ha. Let somebody shout hallelujah.
May one person shout hallelujah.
None of you will die in poverty.
None of you will die for poverty.
I rebuke poverty in your life.
I drive poverty come up for your life.
Finally, he gave me that one.
Last, so you can't give me that sandal.
And because I've never worn shoes before, I had to practice how to walk in it.
Because I know I wear shoes before, I couldn't learn how to walk out with shoes.
But then the day of price giving came.
The day of price giving day can't reach.
And glory be to God, I was in my trousers.
I can't thank God, I come with my borrowed trousers.
I was in my borrowed sandal. Odutola tire sole or not, it doesn't matter.
I come with my sandal, Odutola tire sole, it don't really matter.
I walked up there and got my prize.
I waka go there, I go collect my prize.
Now, if you get hooked up to the God of Abraham,
if you can't take yourself, join the God of Abraham,
there is no way you can die small.
You not get the way when you say you can't die small.
Because he's the God of greatness.
Because now God of greatness.
And I've come to tell you these 3 days. That's why yesterday I said, let us settle our quarrel with God.
That make I tell you now that yesterday, say, make we settle all the quarrel we won't get with God.
Because from now on, in the mighty name of Jesus, greatness is going to be your portion.
Because from this day onward, the greatness is your portion.
Now, when we're talking about greatness, we are not just talking about greatness materially.
When would they talk about greatness? We know they talk about greatness when we say consign only material things.
We're also talking about greatness spiritually.
They see they talk about greatness when person will get for in spiritual things.
This God of Abraham, the one whose name is in another place called Jesus of Nazareth.
This God of Abraham, when another place they can't call him Jesus of Nazareth.
Said, in John chapter 14 verse 12.
You can't talk for John chapter 14 verse 12.
John 14 verse 12.
John chapter 14 verse 12.
He said, the works that I do, you shall do also.
He said, this work when they do, you yourself go see do them too.
And greater works than these shall ye do.
He said, the one will even be past the one that they do, now you go do.
This God of Abraham, if you get hooked up to him, he will empower you to raise the dead.
This God of Abraham, if you can join yourself with him, he will give you the power so that you feel raise the dead.
He will empower you to open blind eyes.
He will give you the power so that you feel open blind eyes.
He will empower you to make the lame walk.
He will empower you so that you will make those people who don't feel waka waka.
Can't you say amen to that one?
You know if you talk amen to this one.
That's the God of Abraham.
And the God of Abraham be that.
Not only that, he is a God of faith.
Not be only that, this God is a God of faith.
In Genesis chapter 15, if you read from verse 2 to 6.
From Genesis chapter 15, if you can read from verse 2 to 6.
Genesis 15, verse 2 to 6.
Genesis chapter 15, verse 2, go read 6.
The Bible said, Abraham said to God, God, you promised.
Abraham called and tell God, say, God, you don't promise me.
You said, through me, the whole world will be blessed.
Say, through me, the whole world will be blessed.
And I'm about to die barren.
And I won't die now, no get picking.
And God said, listen, look up to the sky.
God can tell us, listen, look up to the sky.
Can you count the stars? He said, no.
If he count the stars when they the sky, he said, no, God.
He said, then so shall your children be.
He said, now so your picking will be.
The Bible said, Abraham believed God.
The Bible can't say, Abraham can't believe God.
And it was counted unto him for righteousness.
And they can't count this one, say, Abraham, the righteous.
God of Abraham is the God of faith.
The God of Abraham, a God of faith.
That's why today, whenever we talk about Abraham, we call him the father of faith.
Let me make this day when we talk about Abraham, we call him the papa of faith.
The Bible says in Hebrews chapter 11 verse 6.
The Bible can't talk for Hebrews chapter 11 verse 6.
Hebrews 11 verse 6.
Hebrews 11 verse 6.
He said, without faith it is impossible to please God.
Say, without you not get faith, you not get the way you take on please God.
So if you want to please the God of Abraham, you must be a man or a woman of faith.
If you want to please this God of Abraham, you must be the man or woman of faith.
Now, what is faith?
Now, what it be faith?
We can talk about theology of faith for a long while.
We will talk about the theology of faith for many, many times.
But tell me in a simple language, What exactly is faith?
They tell me for simple language, what does faith can really mean?
Faith simply means, I believe that what God says he will do, he will do it.
Faith just means, say, I believe what God thought he go do, he go feed one.
How? I don't know.
How he go do him? I don't know.
And I don't want to know.
And I don't want to know.
If he is the Almighty and I know he is.
If him na the Almighty and I know say he be.
What, when he says he's going to be well with me, it will be well with me.
When he thought say he go there well with me, I know say he go there well with me.
And I know he had already said it will be well with you.
I already know say God ought to say he go there well with you.
Do I hear you say amen?
I feel here when I thought say amen.
And I will give you examples.
I'm going to give you now an example
of people who are people like you and I.
People like you and myself.
Who have exercised this simple thing called faith.
When they all practice this simple thing when they call faith.
You probably have heard the testimony of a woman.
I believe so. Now hear this testimony of a woman.
Who's been married for, I can't remember now whether 12 or 15 years. This happened early in the 80s.
When they were married for about 12 or 15 years. This one happened for 80s.
And had been barren.
And this woman, not fit born pikin.
And then she heard that the Almighty God is using a certain man of God. And you know, he said, if God is using him like this, then if I can set my eyes on him, I know then I will become pregnant.
Yes, say God, they use one particular man of God. And she can't talk for her mind. Say, if this God really use this man and I just look at him, he said, I go be pregnant.
And she heard that we were going on a tour of our churches in Lagos.
You can hear say, would they go visit our churches when they Lagos?
And the churches were not too many then.
The churches when we get out are not really plenty.
So she went to a particular church, hoping that we would there by 7 o'clock.
She can't go one particular church. She believes that we will reach there by 7 o'clock.
But we were visiting about 3 churches that day. So we came to that church in the afternoon, finished, and went on.
Because now only 3 churches we visit that day, we come that church by afternoon time, we finish and we continue.
She arrived at 6 o'clock, waited and waited and saw nobody.
She come 6 o'clock for evening. She can't wait. She not going to see anybody.
When it was getting dark, he said, what's happening?
One day come they die, come ask, what did they happen?
And somebody saw her and said, what are you waiting for?
One person come see and say, madam, what did they wait for?
Oh, I was waiting for the man of God that they said will be here.
He said, they wait for the man of God when they thought say go come here.
And they said, oh, he had come and he had gone.
They say, he don't come and he don't go.
Oh, then he fell down on the ground and began to weep and said, God, now I know you don't want me to have a child.
She come for ground, come they cry, they use by the road ground, say, God, though, and now I know, say, you don't want me to get picking.
Because I didn't say that I want this man to pray for me.
He said, because I not to say, I want this man make him come pray for me.
I just want to see him.
I just want to see his face.
And now he has come and he has gone.
Now he don't come, he don't go.
Then it means you don't want me to have a child.
He come me say, you don't want me to get picking.
Then somebody told her, no, I heard it announced.
One person can say, no, I hear I want that they announce him.
That he will be at such and such a place tomorrow.
He go so place tomorrow.
I said, then there is still hope.
She go encourage herself, say, well, hope see
the following day, first thing in the morning, he went to that church.
The next day, very early for morning, she can't go to that church.
And waited until we arrived.
She sit down there, they wait until we can't come.
Of course, we arrived, they didn't know who is who.
When we come, she not know who be who.
He wasn't a member of the church.
She not be a member of our church.
But he knew that sooner or later, they will introduce this special guest.
She no say, he not go to this special guest, they will come introduce her.
That has come to visit.
When they come visit.
So she sat down waiting.
She can't sit down, they wait.
And the time came and they introduce us.
The time come reach, they come introduce us.
And when we stood up to begin to preach, he said, is that the man? They said, yes. Yeah. Then glory be to God, I know I am pregnant.
When we can't stand up, can't start to preach, can't ask people, saying, now the man be that, they can't say yes, say glory be to God. Can't say, I know, say, I don't be pregnant.
9 months later, she had a baby boy.
9 months after on a baby boy she can't get.
That is faith.
That one are faith.
I give you another example.
I will tell you now another example.
I got a letter from somebody.
I get one letter from one person.
I don't know who.
I don't know who the person be.
And the fellow said, I am not asking to come and see you.
He said, I'm not the answer, say, make I come see you.
I'm not asking for you to pray for me.
I'm not the answer, say, make you pray for me.
All I'm asking is that you read this letter.
Wait till I hear they ask you, so make you read the letter.
Because I know if you read this letter, my problem will be solved. That's faith.
Because I know, say, if you read this letter, my problem not this solve. That one are faith.
I was dancing in the car when I read that one because I know God will honor such a faith.
And they dance for my motto when I read that letter because I know, say, God will honor that faith.
Some months later, I got another letter.
Some months later, I can't get another letter.
From the same person.
From the same person.
He said, I am sure you read my letter because God has given me my miracle.
He said, I believe, say, you read my letter because God don't give me my miracle.
God will give somebody a miracle here tonight.
God will give somebody a miracle here this night.
I'm going to give you one more example just to let you know what faith is.
I will give you one example more. Make you know what faith means.
Because the problem with many of us is that our faith is not where it ought to be. That's why we have not been receiving our miracles.
The problem with many of us be say our faith not there where it's supposed to be. That make we not receive our miracles.
There are some of us who believe because of our position, because we are so used to seeing the governor and seeing the commissioner and so on.
Some of us, because of our position, because we don't see the governor anyhow, they see the commissioner anyhow.
We believe that until we see the general overseer alone in a room where nobody else is.
We believe so, not until we can see the general overseer for one room when we say nobody did.
And we have told him our history.
I will tell him every of our history.
And he has laid hand on our head.
And he got carry hand put for our head.
And has shaken our head until the neck is almost breaking.
And he got shake our head until our neck won't break.
That nothing is going to happen.
Say nothing will happen.
I think we need to change our attitude.
I believe small will change the way we think.
There was a woman who was dying.
One woman did when they die.
The doctors have told her, no hope for you.
The doctor don't tell the woman, say, no hope for you.
And so she called her children and said, I want you to take me to a Butemeta.
She can't call her Pekin. He said, I want to carry me go to a Butemeta.
I heard there is a church there where God is moving.
I hear say one church there when God moves.
And they said, oh yes, we have heard about the church.
They say, yes, so we don't hear about this church.
But today is not Sunday. The pastor will not be there. Monday is when they have their digging deep. This day, they said, I am not talking of the pastor.
Say, but this day not be Sunday. Say, the pastor not go day there. Monday and Wednesday, they do their digging deep. He say, come tell them, say, I know they talk about the pastor.
Who told you I want to see the pastor?
Who tell you now, say, that the pastor I won't see?
I want to see the God of the pastor.
And that the God of the pastor, I won't see.
Take me to the church.
Carry me go to the church.
They said, but nobody will be there. He said, you think nobody will be there.
They said, but nobody did there. She can't tell her, saying, now you think say nobody did there.
I know God will be there.
I know say God will be there.
Glory be to God forevermore.
Glory be to God forevermore.
How many of you know that God is here already?
How many of you know say God is here already?
How many of you know you will go home with a miracle tonight?
How many of you know say I will go home with miracle this night?
Let me hear you shout hallelujah.
Make a yell and I shout hallelujah.
So they brought the woman.
God carried this woman come.
The doctor said, we don't mind releasing her to you because there's no hope anyway.
The doctor said, we don't mind, we'll carry and give her because no hope there to treat her.
You could as well die on the way as you are going.
She feel die as well as they carry and they go.
Dying, whether she died in the hospital or die in the car, it's not different one from the other.
He said, whether she died for hospital or she can't die for car, no difference there.
So they brought her to the church.
They can't carry her come to the church.
She said, just help me. Carry me inside.
He said, I beg that you help me. Carry me go inside the church.
He carried her inside. He said, get me close to one of the pillars.
They can't carry and go inside. He can't say, I beg that carry me go near one of the pillars.
They got her close to the pillar.
They can't carry her near one of the pillars.
She touched the pillar and said, leave me alone. I don't need your support anymore.
As she touched the pillar, she said, Mona, leave me alone. No, I don't want to support again.
Because as she touched the pillar, the Almighty God who saw her faith sent help from above. And all of a sudden, all sickness, all disease disappeared instantaneously.
As she touched the pillar, the Almighty God, when see her faith, can send help from heaven come down. In order to tell all the sickness, all the disease when they are body, can vanish away.
Let somebody shout hallelujah.
Make one person shout hallelujah.
The God of Abraham, is a God of faith.
The God of Abraham is a God of faith.
When he finds a woman, a man or a woman who will believe him blindly.
When he can't see one man or woman, when he can't believe him, like person who is blind.
Who will say, God, I am in your hand.
When he can't say, God, that your hand are there.
If I live, I live in your hand.
If I can't live, that your hand are live.
If I die, I die in your hand.
And if I can't die, that your hand are die.
I surrender completely to you. You either hold me or I sink.
I carry my body, give you. I beg, make you hold me or else that sink, I go sink.
When he finds somebody like that, he will rise.
When he see person like that, he go stand up.
Like the mighty man of war that he is.
Like the mighty man when he fight war of which he be.
And he will come to your rescue.
And he will come rescue you.
If you don't believe me, ask Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego.
If you not believe me, make una ask Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego.
They said, the God we serve is able to deliver us. Even if he does not, we don't care. We are in his hand.
He said the God when we serve go fit deliver us. And even though he not can deliver us, we not even care because we did inside his hand.
And when you have people like that, before they arrive in the fiery furnace, the fourth man is waiting.
When you get people like that, before they can enter inside that fire when they burn away, the fourth man already did the witness.
And that fourth man is none other than the God of Abraham.
The fourth man will not be any other person but the God of Abraham.
Will somebody say amen to that?
One person, if he say amen to this one.
And then, number six now.
Number six now.
The God of Abraham is a God of worship.
This God of Abraham is a God of worship.
When you read Genesis chapter 12. Verse 6 to 8.
When you read Genesis chapter 12, verse 6, go reach 8.
Genesis 12, verse 6 to 8.
Genesis chapter 12, verse 6, go reach 8.
Genesis 13, verse 1 to 4.
Genesis chapter 13, verse 1, go reach 4.
You will find something significant about Abraham here.
You can see something of important about Abraham.
He is always building altars.
Abraham, they always build altars.
As soon as God called him, Abraham, I'm going to make you of you a great nation. I'm going to make your name great. I'm going to bless you. I'm going to make you a blessing. And I'm going to bless those who bless you and curse those who curse you. Through you, the whole nation of the earth will be blessed. The moment he moved out of his father's house, the first thing he did when he arrived where he was going was that he built an altar.
Our God called Abraham, Abraham, I will make you a great nation. I will make your name great. I will bless you. I will make you a blessing. I will bless those people when bless you. I will curse those people when they curse you. And through you, everybody for this nation will they bless. As he come out from a papa house, the first thing when he do when he reach where they go, he can make a altar.
So that he can worship God.
So he will feel worship God.
Then he went down to Egypt.
He can't go Egypt.
And God said, no, I didn't send you to Egypt.
God can say, no, I'm not sending you go Egypt.
He came back from Egypt.
He can't come out from Egypt.
And he went straight back to that altar to go and worship God.
He can't go back to that altar where he not built before. Can't go worship God.
And then because of the problem between him and Lot.
Later, because of the problem between him and Lot,
there was a lot of fighting, and finally Lot was separated from him.
They get quarrel between them. Last, Lot got separated from him.
And God spoke to him again. As soon as God finished speaking to him, he built yet another altar.
God can't talk to Ram. As God finished to talk to Ram, he can't build another altar.
Abraham was a worshiper.
Abraham, the person when they worship God.
And God is a God of worshippers.
God, not the God of people when they worship him.
Bible said in John chapter 4, verses 23 and 24.
The Bible talk for John chapter 4, verse 23 and 24.
John 4, verse 23 and 24.
John 4, verse 23 and 24.
He said, God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth.
He said, God is a spirit, and those people who worship God must worship God in spirit and in truth.
For God seeketh such to worship him.
For God will look for those people when go worship him.
When the God of Abraham finds anyone who will worship him in spirit and in truth.
When the God of Abraham can see anybody when be say agree to worship him for spirit and truth.
He will do anything for such a person.
He will do anything for that person.
And like I shared with the brethren, I think at the Holy Ghost service.
Like I can't tell the people for Holy Ghost service.
I said the month before I was speaking on deliverance.
The month before that month, I did tell them about deliverance.
I was talking about how Some people, even when the prison doors are open, they will still stay inside.
And they tell you, I say, some people, even when the prison door they open, they will still stay inside.
And I use the example of Paul and Silas.
I can't share the example of Paul and Silas.
And then God corrected me and said, no. In the case of Paul and Silas, I did not open the prison doors for them to come out.
God can't correct me. Can't say, no. Like in the case of Paul and Silas, I don't open the prison gate so that they will come outside.
I open the prison door so that I can come in.
I open the prison door so that me, myself, I will come inside.
I broke in because they were worshipping me.
I break enter inside the prison because they worship me.
May the Almighty God break into your house today.
May the Almighty God make it break enter inside your house today.
I said, may God break into your house today.
I said, may God break enter inside your house today.
See, because if you worship him intensely,
if you worship God well,
if you worship him the way he wants to be worshipped,
if you worship God the way he wants us to worship him,
he will break in.
He will go and break enter inside your house.
And when he breaks in, sickness will have to break out.
When he can't break enter inside your body, sickness will not get sure to go break out.
When he breaks in, poverty will have to get out.
If he breaks in, poverty not get sure so he go cut out.
When he breaks in, demons will just have to leave you alone.
If he breaks in, demon not get sure so they go vamoose away.
If he breaks in, failure will disappear.
If he breaks in, failure will just disappear.
He said, I broke in because they were worshipping me.
I break come inside because they worship me.
I just want to tell those prison doors, they cannot keep me out.
I just want to tell those prison doors, oh, now go fit keep me outside.
When my worshippers are in.
When my worshippers are inside.
The God of Abraham is a God of worshippers.
The God of Abraham is a God of worshippers.
I can give you several examples.
I go fit give you many examples.
Of those who received miracles simply because they worship God.
For those people who won't get miracles because they can't worship God.
You probably have heard me tell the story of a boy that the parents named he careth.
I believe so. Now, Lord, hear this story of a boy when the parents call name, say, God, now they care.
When you get to their house, they will tell you, this is Ayo, this is Taiwo, this is Kehinde.
If you reach their house, they will tell you, say, this one is Ayo, this is Taiwo, this is Kehinde.
What about this one? His name is he careth.
If you go ask them, what will be this one name? The name now, God, now they take care.
When you hear such a strange name, you want to ask, why do you call this one he careth? So it will give them an opportunity to tell you a story.
When you hear that kind of name, or when you say you know I hear before, you come to wonder why be say when they call this speaking, saying that God now they take care. You can't make them feel, can't tell you the story.
That they left Nigeria for America on government scholarship.
They come out from Nigeria go to America because government give them scholarship.
And then when they got there, the government canceled their scholarship.
When they call rich American, in order to take, government can't cancel their scholarship.
And they became stranded.
And they can't get money, they couldn't suffer for them.
In the meantime, they've already got 3 children.
Before that time, when they get 3 children.
They've got Ayo, they've got Taiwo, they've got Kehinde.
They get Ayo, they get Taiwo, they get Kehinde.
And there was not a kobo for them to spend.
And they don't get one single money to spend.
The husband was a student, the wife had no job, and there was no food in the house.
The husband as student, the wife not get any work, and they not get single food for house.
So the children began to cry for food.
So the children, they start to cry for food.
The two twins, the young twins that have just been born, they were shouting for food.
The young twins, when they just born, they cry for food.
The mother had no food to eat, so the breast was even drying up of milk.
The mama not get food to eat. The breast when the pikin supposed to suck, or they dry up of milk.
They had prayed.
They don't pray.
They had bound, they had loose, nothing had happened.
They don't bound, they don't loose, nothing don't happen.
Then so the husband couldn't take it any longer. You know, man, he checked out. He said he was going to the library to read.
The husband not feel will stand this one. You know the way men they do it. Yours come out. He said they go library, they go read.
But the mother was left alone with the 3 children who are crying for food.
The woman can't deal with the 3 children when they cry because they don't see food shop.
And then the mother remembered that I had taught them years ago because they were my children here.
The woman can't remember, say, many years will not pass. Say the GO don't teach them something because they'll be spiritual children to the GO.
That when you try prayers and prayers fail.
So when you try prayers and prayers fail.
Then try praise.
Say make you switch over to praise.
So she got her tambourine and began to praise God.
She can't carry her tambourine, come outside, come to praise God.
He said, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want.
So say the Lord that my shepherd and not go feel want.
Etc.
Like that, like that.
And as she was praising God, there was a group of men who were doing house-to-house witnessing.
As she did praise God, though, they get a group of some men when we say they do house-to-house witnessing.
And they were tired, they wanted to go home.
They're not tired or they won't go home.
But then something said to the leader, no, one more house.
Something can tell the leader, say, no, but we still attend to one more house.
And they came to the house where this sister was playing the tambourine and praising God.
They can't come this house when we say this sister, they when they beat the tambourine, they praise God.
They knocked the door, he opened, and they said, do you know Christ?
They knocked the door and the sister can open the door. They can ask and say, you know Jesus Christ?
Oh, he said, you want to talk about Jesus coming?
He said, you want to talk about Jesus Christ? Come inside.
I know him.
Tell them, say, I know him.
They came in. They talked about Jesus for a while.
They come inside. They can't talk about Jesus Christ for some time.
When the children saw this white man, they stopped crying for a while.
When these children, they cry before because of food, see this white man, they can't stop to cry for some time.
And when they finish all the talking, the young lady said, I would have offered you something, but there's nothing in this house.
When they can't finish all the talk, when they talk, the woman can't tell them, say, I've forgiven her something, though. They bet nothing there inside this house.
And the leader said, what do you mean, nothing in this house?
The leader come to us, what do you mean, say, nothing there in this house?
Not even a pop.
He said, not even a pop.
He said, absolutely nothing in this house.
He said, nothing there in this house.
You know, pop is the American for Coca-Cola or Fanta or whatever.
You know, pop, now, language where they call Coca-Cola or Fanta.
Anyway. So they went and opened the fridge to be sure.
They can't go open the fridge, made a day sure for waiting this woman, they tell them.
And the fridge was empty.
This fridge, they empty.
They went to the kitchen, empty.
They go to the kitchen, they empty.
What's going on?
They can't ask the woman, what did they happen?
The lady explained.
The woman can't tell them.
And the leader said, wait a minute.
The leader can say, wait for us. So.
We'll return in a moment.
We'll come back soon.
They went to the store nearby. Got all the groceries.
The leader can't go to the store when near them. Can't go buy many provisions.
Brought food and everything.
Can't bring food and many things.
And that day at least, there was food in the house.
For that day at least, so they get food to shop.
Glory be to God forevermore.
Glory be to God forevermore.
And the following week, they got a job for the husband. And got a job for the wife.
The week went follow. They can't give the husband job. And they can't give the wife job also.
Let somebody shout another hallelujah.
Make one person shout another hallelujah.
The baby that they gave back to after that one is the one they named Ikeare.
The pikin they can't give back to after that katakata when they don't undergo, then they can't name God that they take care of.
I was in America last month. And I saw a young man on the keyboard.
At the American last month, I can't see one young man when they keyboard.
Singing, praising God, dancing as he was playing the keyboard.
The man is sing, they dance as they play the keyboard.
Until he attracted my attention. I said, who is that fellow? He's praising my God the way I would love to if I know how to play the keyboard.
As the man they do this thing, the thing can't make me see him easily. I can't ask them, say, who be this person? This person, they praise God the way I like to if I sabi how to play keyboard.
And they say, oh, that boy, he has a strange name.
They can say, oh, that boy, he gets one funny name.
I said, what is the name?
I said, what is my name?
Ikeare.
I say, Ikeare.
Glory be to God forevermore.
Glory be to God forevermore.
There are some of us who are here today. We had prayed.
Many of us there here when we say we don't pray.
We had fasted.
We don't fast.
We have done everything.
We don't do everything.
We have attended all kinds of deliverance services.
We don't attend every kind of deliverance services.
And we are still in our problem.
And we still there inside our problem.
The God of Abraham is calling on you today and say, all you need to do is worship me.
The God of Abraham, they call us today. Say, all what you need to do now to worship him.
Forget prayers.
Make you forget prayers.
Forget fasting.
Make you forget fasting.
Forget everything. They're all good.
Make you forget all those things. They're good though.
But just worship me.
But just worship me.
If you worship me, I will break in.
If you worship me, I'll come break, come meet you.
And when I break in, your problems will be over.
When I come break in, come meet you, your problem will be over.
Will somebody shout another hallelujah?
Make another person shout another hallelujah.
People have asked me again and again, when we come to your meetings.
People don't ask me again and again, say, when will come your meeting?
We don't see you binding demons.
We know they see you say you bind demons.
And casting out devils.
They cast devils.
Before we begin the service.
Before we come start the service.
Why don't you do that?
Why you know they can't do that?
Because I said there's no need.
I tell you, I said no need.
Number one, I thought you said you bound the devil yesterday.
Number one, I think someone said when I bound the devil yesterday.
Did he get loose overnight?
He can't lose himself overnight.
Number two. Why should I waste my time dealing with darkness?
Why I go to waste my time to deal with darkness?
When all I need to do is bring in the light.
When all waiting I need to do now to carry light come.
If we can just worship him, he will come in.
If we just worship him, he will come inside.
And when he come in, there's no demon that can stay.
When he come inside, no demon gets head when go fit stay.
That's one of the reasons why I always start by saying, let somebody shout hallelujah.
That be the reason. Anytime I start, I will say, make one person shout hallelujah.
Let me begin to close.
Make I start to the round up.
The God of Abraham is the God of the highest standard.
This God of Abraham, now God when we say standard, they high pass all that one.
Genesis chapter 17 verse 1.
But Genesis chapter 17 verse 1.
Genesis 17 verse 1.
Genesis chapter 17 verse 1.
He said unto Abraham, he said, Abraham, I am the Lord God Almighty.
He can't tell Abraham, say, Abraham, I be the God, Lord God Almighty.
Jehovah El Shaddai.
The Jehovah El Shaddai.
Walk thou before me and be thou perfect.
Make you walk, they follow me and make you day perfect.
Brethren, don't let anybody deceive you.
My brother and my sister, make you not let anybody deceive you.
If you want to walk with the God of Abraham, you must get ready for the highest standard possible.
If you want to walk with this God of Abraham, you must be yourself to walk in a standard when we say they high pass every other one.
The God of Abraham is a God of no nonsense.
This God of Abraham, now God when we say no, they tolerate nonsense.
It's not a God that you can joke with.
Not be God when we say you fit it do yeah.
It's not a God that you can pretend to be a Christian and be something else. He will not take it from you.
Not be God when we say you tell and say you be Christian, but you they do something else. He not go take this one from you.
The God of Abraham is very strict.
The God of Abraham, he is strict well.
He is a holy God.
A God when we say they holy.
Mighty, powerful.
They mighty, they powerful.
A very good friend.
Now friend when we say they very good.
But a very terrible enemy.
But now terrible enemy also.
I will be failing in my duty if I don't tell you the truth, the whole truth and nothing but the truth.
I go fail for my duty if I not tell you now the truth and the whole truth and nothing but the truth.
You cannot become associated with the God of Abraham and continue to lie.
You not go feel deal with the God of Abraham and you continue to tell lies.
And continue to cheat.
And you see the cheat.
And to continue to play games.
And you see the play games.
He will not take it from you.
You not go feel take this one from you.
He said in Matthew chapter 5 verse 48.
He talked from Matthew chapter 5 verse 48.
Matthew 5 verse 48. He said, be ye therefore perfect, even as your Father in heaven is perfect.
Matthew 5 verse 48. He said, make you day perfect to as your Papa when they heaven, they perfect.
The standard of perfection that the God of Abraham requires from you is not even the standard of perfection of the Geo.
The type of perfection when God of Abraham wants from you, not be the standard when we say the Geo does set to.
It's the standard of perfection of the Almighty God Himself.
Now the standard when God Himself does set.
That is His standard.
That na His own standard.
And it doesn't bend.
And this is standard we know the bend him.
It doesn't change with time.
This standard not change at all as time they go.
He is not a modern God.
Not be God of this modern days.
He's as old as the ages.
He not old as the age be.
It's a very conservative God.
This God, now God when BC they protect what he talk.
Is the same yesterday.
Now the same yesterday.
Today and forever.
Today and he could still remain the same forever.
The same dress, that he was wearing when the world was created is what he's still wearing today.
This dress when he wear when they create the world, and that same dress is still wearing.
So I see quite a few of you who think that it is modern to wear a dress that is showing almost everything that we are supposed to be hiding.
I can't see say some of them. I want to say because when I don't sabi well, when they modern, when I can't wear dress, when we say they show everything when we say supposed to hide.
You can't walk with the God of Abraham like that.
You know, go feel the walk with the God of Abraham like the way you dress.
And I know there are some of you who say the reason you slit your skirt is so that you'll be able to walk free.
Some of them I thought say the reason one that put slit for our skirt so that now feel the worker free.
Who asked you to sew it tight to start with?
Who can't tell you make you sew it tight?
The God of Abraham is the God that we only walk with you if you come to church dressed in such a way that you can worship him.
The God of Abraham, that God when we say go only walk with you when you come to church and you dress well, when you feel worship him.
Any dress that you cannot bend down to dance for Jesus Christ, that dress is out from tonight. Do I hear you say amen?
Any dress when we say you no go feel wear and you can't bend down the dance for Jesus Christ, that dress will, you're supposed to write them out from tonight. I feel here on that thought say amen.
The God I serve is not a cheap God.
The God when they serve, that be God when they sheep.
He's the Almighty.
And the Almighty God he be.
His name is Jehovah El Shaddai.
His name is Jehovah El Shaddai.
He's a God who is more than enough.
This not God will be say big pass what we need.
It's not a God you can treat lightly.
That be God when you be say your feet take here, yeah.
That's why he said anything you can give to your president, don't offer it to me. I'm not begging you for anything.
I make it to say anything you know if you give your president, may you not give me because I don't need that from you.
Anyway, you cannot treat your government. No, don't treat God like that.
Anyway, you know, if you treat your governor, I beg, not treat God like that.
When the God of Abraham says, I want you to be with me at 5 o'clock, you better be there by 4:30.
When the God of Abraham says, I want you, may you be with me by 5 o'clock, I beg, go try reach there before 4:30.
Because if the president asks you to come and see him at 10 a.m., I'm sure you'll be there by 8 a.m.
I believe, say, if the president can't make you can't see him by 10 a.m., I believe before 8 a.m., you don't reach there.
The God of Abraham is a no-nonsense God.
The God of Abraham, a God when we say, no, they take here, yeah.
I'll give you just one example.
I will give you now one example.
Some of you have heard it before.
Some of you have not heard this one before.
And with that, we will close.
With this example, we will conclude.
Years ago, we had a campground somewhere in Ekpe.
In that too, many years when they passed, we get one campground for Ekpe.
And we wanted to dig some pit latrine there.
I want dig some pit latrine for that place.
And I gave the contract to a surveyor.
I can't carry this work, give one surveyor like that.
A man who had been to the university and qualified as a surveyor.
This person don't go to university and they don't qualify him as a surveyor.
We agreed that he was going to dig for us two pit latrines, 60 feet by 8 feet.
Both of us were agreed, saying that two pit latrines you go dig, 60 feet by 8 feet.
I think by 6 feet.
6 feet by 6 feet.
And we've agreed on how much we are going to pay.
And we don't agree how much I go pay him.
So I took him to the site.
I can't carry and go to the place.
And then when he began to measure the first one, instead of measuring in feet, he started to measure in meters.
When did they measure the first one? Instead of you go measure in feet, now meters you can't measure.
God spoke to me and said, correct him.
God can't talk to me, say my picking correct him.
I said, no, Lord.
I said, no, Lord.
If he's a surveyor, if he has been to the university.
If not surveyor and he don't go to university.
And he doesn't know the difference between feet and meters, that's his own headache.
I don't know the difference between feet and meters. Now your own headache be that.
God said, correct him. I said, no, Lord.
God can tell me, say, correct him. I said, no, Lord.
We got to the second place.
We can't go to the second place.
He started measuring. I thought that maybe he would discover his mistake himself.
He can't start to the measure. I just say he go can't correct himself.
And got there and he began to measure in meters again instead of feet.
He can't see the measure in meters again instead of feet.
And Lord spoke to me. I said, son, I said, correct him. I said, no.
God can't tell me, say, my picking. I say, make you correct him. I say, no.
If this fellow claims to be a graduate,
if this person Just say he be graduate.
And he doesn't know the difference between meters and feet. He deserves to suffer.
I don't know the difference between meters and feet. Now suffer is supposed to suffer.
God kept quiet.
God come quiet.
And he finished measuring, and we were about to go.
After he don't finish to measure, we won't go now.
And then there was one hefty Hausa man, you know, one of those who are going to help him dig.
As we go, we can see one Hausa man went big way. This is not people won't go up and dig.
And he smiled at me. He says, "Sir, no," and I smiled back.
He smiled to me and he says, "Sir, no," I can't smile back to him.
And I want to be a good pastor, so I stretch forth my hand to shake his hand.
I
want to
be a good pastor, so I can't stretch my hand and shake him.
And you know, those who dig, their hands can be strong.
And believe so, and I know, say, those people when they dig, their hand is strong, well.
And this man grabbed my hand. And for no reason at all, he just began to squeeze.
This man can't grab my hand. For no reason at all, this man can't start to squeeze my hand.
And it was as if iron clamps were squeezing my hand.
Job like saying, iron, they squeeze my hand.
I mean, all of a sudden, it was as if my bones were going to crack.
Job like say, you know, go to my bones go soon start to crack.
God, why?
I can only pray, say, God, why now?
God spoke to me. I told you to correct him.
God can't tell me, say, I tell you, may you correct him.
All right, Lord, all right. And then the man released my hand.
I can say, okay, God, okay, I will correct him. In order to tell the man, I can release my hand.
Now you are laughing.
Now they laugh.
Because it was in your hand.
Because not be on the hand.
So I corrected him.
I can't correct him.
And as I was going back to the car, my hand was burning like fire.
As I couldn't go my car, my hand they burn like say fire day.
When I got into the car, I said, God, but the punishment is too much for the offense.
When I reached my car, I can say, God, this punishment is when you give me a big pass, what I do.
God spoke to me, I said, I have told you that you are special unto me. I will tolerate no nonsense.
God can't tell me, can't say, I don't tell you, say you did special to me. I don't go take nonsense.
That is the God of Abraham.
And the God of Abraham be that.
How many of you still want to be associated with him?
How many of you now want to deal with the God of Abraham?
Let's stand on our feet.
Moku, stand up.
Thank you, my father.
Thank you, my papa.
Oh, glory be to God.
Glory be to God.
Before we do anything else tonight, I want you to worship the God of Abraham. He's a God of worship.
Before we do anything this night, I want to make you worship the God of Abraham because he's a God of worship.
I want you just to lift your hands to him and just bless his holy name.
I want make una bless his holy name.
And just say, Lord of Abraham, I bless you.
Make una say, God of Abraham, I bless you.
Lord of Abraham, I adore you.
God of Abraham, I adore you.
Lord of Abraham, I glorify. Open your mouth and worship him.
God of Abraham, I glorify you. Open your mouth, make you worship him.
As you worship him, he will break through.
As you worship him, he will break, come inside.
He's the God of worship.
Now, God of worship.
I want you to adore him.
I want make you adore him.
I want you to magnify his holy name.
I want make you magnify his holy name.
He is the God of Abraham.
Now, God of Abraham.
He is the God that is above all gods.
Now, God won't be say big past every other God.
There is no one like him.
No God be like him.
He is the God of Abraham.
Now, God of Abraham, now he be.
Magnify his holy name.
Make him magnify his holy name.
It's worthy to be praised.
Now, him alone, now we will feel praise.
It's worthy to be adored.
Now, him alone, we will feel adored.
It's worthy to be magnified.
Now, him alone, now we're supposed to magnify.
There is no one like him.
No one be like him.
All power belong to him.
Every power, now him get him.
It's Jehovah El Shaddai.
Now, him be Jehovah El Shaddai.
It's the I am that I am.
Now, him be the I am, when be the I am.
He's the unchangeable Lord.
Now, him be the God, when not the change.
Oh, worship the God of Abraham.
Make you worship the God of Abraham.
Worship the God of Abraham.
Make you worship the God of Abraham.
Worship the God of Abraham.
Make you worship the God of Abraham.
He reigns forever.
He reigns forever.
Oh, there is no one like him.
Nobody be like him.
He's the greatest.
Now, he's great, pastor.
He's the highest.
Now he high past all.
He's the oldest.
Now he old past all.
Worship the God of Abraham.
Make you worship the God of Abraham.
Worship the God of Abraham.
Make you worship the God of Abraham.
Worship him.
Make you worship him.
Adore him.
Make you adore him.
Bless his holy name.
Make you bless his holy name.
Tell him how great thou art.
Make you tell him how great rich.
How great thou art.
How great rich.
How great thou art.
How great rich.
How great thou art.
How great rich.
Worship the God of Abraham.
Make you worship the God of Abraham.
Worship the God of Abraham.
Make you worship the God of Abraham.
Worship the God of Abraham.
Make you worship the God of Abraham.
Worship the God of Abraham.
Make you worship the God of Abraham.
Worship the God of Abraham.
Make you worship the God of Abraham.
It's worthy, it's worthy, it's worthy, it's worthy to be praised.
Is they worthy, is they worthy, is they worthy, and is they worthy make we praise him.
Worship him until we break through.
Worship him until he can't break coming to you.
And break through into your situation.
And he can't break come meet you because of your situation.
Worship him.
Make you worship him.
And he will break every prison door.
And he will break every prison door.
Worship him.
Make you worship him.
He will cut the bars of brass in sunder.
He will cut all the chain on the anchor when they use the anchor few. Go scatter all of them.
Oh yes, call on him. Worship him.
Yes, so make gonna call on him. Gonna worship him.
Tell him. God of Abraham.
Make una tell and say, God of Abraham.
I love you.
I love you.
I adore you.
I adore you.
I magnify your holy name.
I magnify your holy name.
What a God you are.
That are the kind God when you be.
What a marvelous God you are.
You be God when they marvelous.
What a mighty God you are.
You be God when they mighty.
God of Abraham.
You na God of Abraham.
You are wonderful.
You dey wonderful.
You are great.
You dey great.
You are powerful.
You get power well well.
You are majestic.
You big well well. You get influence.
You are loving. You are kind.
You dey lovely. You dey kind well well.
You are reliable.
Best if you rely on you.
Oh, God of Abraham.
God of Abraham.
What a great God you are.
You be great God indeed.
What a marvelous God you are.
You dey marvelous well well.
What a powerful God you are.
You dey powerful well well.
Blessed be your name forever, God of Abraham.
Blessed be your name, you God of Abraham.
Blessed be your name forever, God of Abraham.
Blessed be your name, this God of Abraham.
Blessed be your name forever, God of Abraham.
Blessed be your name, you God of Abraham.
Thank you, 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 God of Abraham. We worship you.
Thank you, God of Abraham. I worship you.
In Jesus' mighty name, we have worshiped.
In Jesus' mighty name, we don't worship.
Now, I told you at the beginning that the God of Abraham is a God of choice.
I don't tell you now before, for beginning, say God of Abraham, that God will be the select.
We're going to thank him for choosing us, those of us who are already chosen by him for salvation.
We go thank God for, we will be God already select us.
And as we begin to thank him for choosing us, because whosoever he chooses for salvation, he also chooses for greatness.
We will thank him because he does select us. Because anybody who he does select for salvation, he does also select that person, make the person day great.
Whosoever he chooses for salvation, he chooses for blessing.
Anybody who he does select for salvation, he doesn't select the person to bless him.
If there's anyone here, inside here, outside there, in the chapel there.
If anyone when they hear, they inside there, or they outside there, or they for the chapel.
Where well, I'm sure you can hear me clearly. If there's any one of you,
when I sure say, when I go feel they hear me clear, clear.
That's not a born again today, and you have heard this message.
If anyone they were missing, why give your life to Jesus Christ, and you don't hear this message,
and you want to surrender to the God of Abraham,
and you won't give your life to the God of Abraham.
I'm not going to ask you just to raise your hand tonight. I want you to come right here and come and stand in front of me.
I'm not going to tell you that I just raise your hand this night to bear. I want you now to come front, come stand for my front.
I want you to come and show to the whole world that the God of Abraham has been speaking to you, and you want to surrender your life to him.
I want to show the whole world, say, the God of Abraham, don't they talk to you? You don't come, come give your life to him.
Everywhere, I want you to begin to come now, and I want this camera removed from here.
Everywhere on that day, I want to make una they come. I want this camera made a carrier come up from this place.
Now, the rest of us that have been chosen, I want you to begin to talk to the Almighty God.
The rest of us, when we say God already selected you now, I want more than they tell the Almighty God.
I say, God of Abraham, thank you for choosing me.
When I say, God of Abraham, I thank you so you don't choose me.
Thank you for choosing my family.
Thank you because you don't choose my family.
Thank you for choosing me for salvation.
Thank you because you don't choose me for salvation.
Thank you for choosing me for love.
Thank you because you don't choose me for love.
Thank you for choosing me for blessing.
Thank you because you don't choose me for blessing.
If you want to give your life to Jesus, come now.
If you want to give your life to Jesus, I beg, come now.
Come and stand right here in front of me.
Make you come stand for my front.
Come from all over the place.
May you come from every area of the place.
Come. The God of Abraham is calling you.
Make you come. The God of Abraham, they call you.
Come now.
Make you come.
Come now. Come now.
Come now. Make you come now.
And the rest of all, let's thank him that he has chosen us.
Many of us, but we thank God because God always chooses us.
Choosing us for salvation.
God always chooses us for salvation.
Choosing us for blessings.
God always chooses us for blessings.
Choosing us for greatness.
God always chooses us for greatness.
Let's thank him. Open your mouth and thank the God of Abraham.
Make you open your mouth, may you thank the God of Abraham.
Thank him.
Make you thank him.
Thank him for the salvation of your soul.
Make you thank him because of the salvation of your soul.
Thank him for choosing you.
Thank him because he does choose you.
Yes, bless his holy name.
Make you bless his holy name.
Bless his holy name.
Make you bless his holy name.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Papa.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
In Jesus' mighty name we do pray.
I want to pray for those of you who have come for salvation first.
I want to pray for those people when they'll come as I can't give their life to Jesus Christ first.
Before we go into some very serious prayers that we want to pray tonight.
Before we can't go pray some serious prayer what we're supposed to pray this night.
And please, if you are coming to answer the altar call, keep coming.
If when they come, you can't give their life to Jesus Christ. I bet more than still they come. Oh.
Keep coming. Once you get here, before I finish praying, it is all right.
If you feel rich here before I finish to pray, it is okay.
So keep coming, keep coming.
So make you, they come.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
In the mighty name of Jesus.